In India, both bacterial and fungal corneal ulcers occur in equal proportions. So, it becomes very important to identify the organism and start the specific therapy. Microbiology services include sample collection, sample processing, and identification of the organisms. Sample collection. Commonly, samples are collected in cases of infectious keratitis, endophthalmitis, conjunctivitis, blepharitis, and abscesses of the ocular adnexa. Corneal scraping in keratitis, conjunctival swab in conjunctivitis, pus in abscess, and vitreous sample is collected in case of endophthalmitis. Laboratory workup of corneal ulcers should be done in a deliberate and meticulous manner. Corneal ulcer is scraped using a 15-number blade attached to a Bart Parker handle. 11-number blades should not be used for scraping as they are too sharp to tear the cornea. Scraping is performed from the edge and base of the ulcer using topical anesthesia. Topical anesthetic used is 0.5% proparacaine drops. All the necrotic material should be removed from the ulcer surface using a sterile blade or a Kimura spatula. Scraped sample is placed on a slide, crushed, and spread to prepare a smear which is stained and examined under microscope. The sample used for KOH mount is not crushed. Instead, a drop of 10% KOH is added and covered by a cover slip. The sample is carefully plated on agar plates. Blood agar, chocolate agar, Saberode's dextrose agar, potato dextrose agar, brain heart infusion broth are used. The scraped tissue should be placed as multiple C-shaped streaks on the culture plate so that the growth on the C-shaped streak can be noted in a decreasing gradation. Smears are generally not made from the sample, such as contact lens solutions, intraocular lenses, corneal biopsies or buttons, and iris tissue. They are directly plated on the culture plates. Advantage of direct plating is that it gives abundant material in the culture media and chances of positive culture is much more. Contact lens solution is dropped from the solution bottle into the media and is spread in the agar plate using a sterile swab. There are certain precautions which should be taken while collecting the samples. They are as follows. The blade should not touch the lid margins or the conjunctiva as they harbor normal resident flora which may give false results. Scraped material should be immediately plated on culture plates to avoid contamination. Slide should be held from the edge. The 15-number blade should not be touched. Cotton swabs should not be used for sample collection. The examiner should not talk while plating the media as this may cause contamination. No transport media is used and direct patient-side processing is the rule. Gentle scraping should be done in cases of corneal thinning and impending perforations as vigorous scraping may lead to a perforation. Staining of smears, Gram staining. All the smears are stained by this technique. Direct smears are made from the scraped tissue as well as from the colonies grown on the culture media. Smear is flooded with crystal violet for 1 minute and washed with tap water. Smear is flooded with Gram's iodine for 1 minute and decolorized using Gram's decolorizer. Smear is counterstained with safranin for 1 minute and dried. Morphology of the organism as well as Gram reaction are noted. Morphologically, bacteria found are cocci, bacilli or cocobacilli. They can be either gram-positive or gram-negative. Gram-positive bacteria appear purple while gram-negative appear pink. Gram-positive bacteria in chain, gram-positive bacteria in clusters, diplococci, gram-negative cocci, gram-negative bacilli, microsporidia spores, acanthamoeba cyst. Gene sustaining. Gene sustaining of ulcer scraping is generally done to identify parasites like acanthamoeba and fungi. This stain is very useful to identify elementary bodies of Chlamydia trachomatis. They stain purple to blue against a grayish cytoplasm. Acid fast staining, also known as Zeal-Nelson staining. It is performed when infectious keratitis due to atypical organisms like nocardia and atypical mycobacteria is suspected. KOH mount. It is performed to detect fungal hyphae and occasionally acanthamoeba cysts. Smear examination is a rapid method of identification. It helps in starting the initial therapy. Information provided by smear examination needs to be confirmed by culture. Culture. Culturing the sample helps in two ways. It confirms the initial information provided by the smear examination. Organisms grown on a culture can be subjected to antibiotic susceptibility. Culture plates are incubated at 37 degrees Celsius for 1 week, except saburate dextrose agar, which requires 25 to 27 degrees Celsius, and chocolate agar is incubated in 3 to 5% carbon dioxide in a candle jar. Bacteria generally grow within 24 hours. Fungi take longer than bacteria to grow. By 48 hours, growth can be seen in culture media. Final identification can be done by studying the colony characteristics and microscopic findings. Antibiotic susceptibility. Once the organism is identified, antibiotic susceptibility test is performed. This test is carried out because susceptibility can vary even with the species of a bacteria known to be sensitive to a particular antibiotic. Moreover, with the emerging resistance to antibiotics, it becomes important to identify the most sensitive antibiotic for that particular organism. Testing for antibiotic sensitivity is mostly done by Kirby-Boyer method. Small wafers containing the antibiotics are placed onto a plate upon which bacteria are growing. If the bacteria are sensitive to the antibiotic, a clear ring or a zone of inhibition is seen around the wafer indicating poor growth. Müller-Hinton agar is most commonly used media to conduct antibiotic sensitivity. Clear zone is measured using antibiotic zone scales, and hence the sensitivity to a particular antibiotic is quantified. Targeted therapy is the aim for all ocular infections, and microbiological processing plays a very crucial role in identifying the correct organism and sensitive antibiotic. This ultimately helps in speedy recovery of the patient.